Welcome back to Down to Earth Outdoors, y'all. Doing a little whatever's gonna bite fishing. So, show you my little rig here. We start a little panfish pole, 10 footer. Well, what I got here, you can go all the way up. I'm gonna do that here in a minute. I'm gonna put probably 3 or 4 jigs, two more jigs on here. But as you guys can see, that one, I just got tied on like a weight. I only got it tied twice, and that thing ain't going nowhere. Sorry for cursing. And then the bottom, I got it tied 8 times because it's at the very bottom. Right here, you only have to tie twice. Right here, you only have to tie twice. Now you have to take these two off, cut your line to start up here, and then you go down. You can't add another one up here once you got these two on, if that makes sense. So let's get into it, y'all. I already caught a largemouth bass just a second ago. I'll show you guys, but let's see what we can get. That's a good one. Oh man. What in the what? How? Did that even happen? What the? Part of fishing, guys. Don't do that. Them two jiggers won't shake out like a one jigger will. All I'm doing is kind of working it up and down, side to side, anywhere. Nothing special here, just trying to see if we can get something. Usually right. trees and stuff, guys. It's feeding time in the morning, so these bass and catfish, everything's trying to come up and get these little bait fish along the, you know, along the edge of the lake here. They hide up in the little holes and grass and all kinds of good stuff along the edge of the lake. I'll be back in a minute, guys. I'm gonna redo this. They're biting off that the darker ones right now, so see you guys here in a minute. Welcome back, y'all. As y'all can see, I got 3 jigs on here now. I found what color they were biting off of. I had a couple different colors on there. They were obviously after the darker colors, like the color was worms. So got 3 jigs just like that. Them two are just tied once on there, guys, because there's no need to tie them like you do the bottom one, because they got enough slack to tighten up. This one won't have enough slack to tighten up, so you got to tie it regular, just like, you know, the 8-time loop through the hole, back around, you know how it is. But that's how it should look, guys. Just jig them across the water. Let me show you guys, see if we can catch some fish. And let me show you a little secret. After you're done manhandling these with your fingers and teeth and all kinds of stuff, spray some stuff on there, guys. I got some panfish stuff from Walmart. So I'm going to spray every one of them jigs with that to hide human scent is what I'm doing right now. Because they can pick up on human scent just like anything else out in the wild. I ain't spraying too much. This stuff lasts forever. Let's see if we can catch something. don't want them. That's what I'm talking about though, them sticks that's laying up against the edge from the water, kicking it to the edge of the water, them fish love living up in them. They're not wanting to bite. Well, keep getting a nibble right here, but it's probably a little bluegill. He ain't wanting to snap on it. Got a pretty good size largemouth bass. I mean, it wasn't big, but I'll show it to you guys here in a minute. Take this bobber off here, probably help me a little bit so I can work the jig a little bit more. Always keep your stuff in your pocket, guys. It's easy to run off in a hurry and leave something. You don't want to leave it for the next guy. Pick up your expensive fish and stuff. That stuff's gone up crazy. For 4 or 5 hooks, you're paying like $6 now. I've never remember it being that high. Alright, y'all, I'll start you back when we start getting more bites. Thought we were getting bites there for a minute. Right here, let me set you all up. To the 808 over there to the left. I'm gonna reel her in a little bit. Pull that slag up. See that, guys? Little nibbles on the edge right there. Freaking turtles, man. I'm gonna throw her out in a different spot. One splash is good. More than two splash, or you know, more than one splash, reel her back in, your bait's off your hook. Learn that plenty of times. Alright, guys, I'm gonna shut you off and I'll put you back on over here once we start getting bites on our other pole. Our 3 jigger. One splash is good, 2 ain't. If you ain't getting bites within like 20 minutes, guys, crank her in a little bit, about halfway, let her set a little bit longer. Don't get any more bites. Reel her all the way in and cast it somewhere else. Don't get any bites anywhere. Go to a different spot. Here's this largemouth we caught. We're gonna throw her back, but I don't like catching the same fish, so we'll throw her back when we leave. She's a pretty good size one. I mean, there ain't nothing to it. You know, definitely bigger than my hand. Pretty one. My top, my net, my live net's messing up, guys. A little tip, make sure you always check the bottom and top of your live nets and set it at an angle to where your top's always just, you know, tightly up like that, and just move your rope and anchor it down. See you guys here in a little bit. Hope y'all can see. It's pretty sunny on the screen, so I'm gonna assume y'all can see. I'm gonna toss this girl out here real quick. Welcome back, y'all. Sorry it's crooked. We got something on the blue line. I'm gonna get her. Get my net.
Oh man, the damn turtle. Big one too. I want my hook.
we go, boys.
Big old son of a gun. I'm getting my dang hook back. Big old snapper. I don't know how, but I'm gonna get her back. Know that. Guess just like this.
Yee yee!
Down to earth outdoors, baby.
Dang, he's aggressive.
Alright, y'all. Let me get this. I'm just gonna have to throw him back. But thought it was a catfish, guys. See y'all later.